state law requires sellers and buyers to test breeding bulls for trichomonas, or trich, before changing ownership. As a veterinarian, it is crucial that you receive accurate test results. To ensure this, your clinic must follow the correct procedures for handling, packaging, and shipping trich samples to the diagnostic lab. In this video, we will cover the following: the two forms you must submit for an official state test, the proper medium for collecting and shipping your sample, your testing options, including the pooling of samples, how to store or incubate the samples, how to package a sample for shipment. If you are officially testing a breeding bull to meet Texas state regulations, you must submit the sample to TVMDL with a test record from the Texas Animal Health Commission and a lab submission form provided by TVMDL. You can download these forms at the TVMDL website. It is important to complete each form fully and properly. There is only one acceptable medium for collecting trich samples for an official test: the in-pouch TF. Before using a pouch, check the expiration date. Never use an expired pouch. Use a permanent marker to record the bull's official identification number and the collection date on the label. Never write on the clear area of the pouch. The bull's identification number on the pouch must match the test record. TVMDL offers two official tests for trich. The first is a culture. The second is a PCR test, or polymerase chain reaction. To select a culture, check the appropriate box on the trich test record. If you submit a sample for culture, it must arrive at TVMDL within 48 hours of collection. To select a PCR test, check the appropriate box on the test record. If you submit a sample for a PCR test, it should arrive at TVMDL within 48 hours of collection. Sometimes this is not possible. If not, you may incubate the sample for up to 48 hours at temperatures between 36 degrees and 38 degrees Celsius. Under state regulations, an incubated sample must arrive at TVMDL within 120 hours of collection. You must complete the clinic incubation section of the test record. This section indicates how long you have incubated the sample at your clinic. You have three options. Please only check one. The first option is none. Checking this box says you have not incubated the sample. If you select this box, the lab must incubate the sample for 48 hours before testing it. The second option is 24 hours. Checking this box says that you have incubated the sample for 24 hours. If you select this box, the lab must incubate the sample for an additional 24 hours before testing it. The third option is 48 hours. Checking this box says you have incubated the sample for 48 hours. If you select this box, the lab will test the sample without any additional incubation. If the lab receives a test record with none of the boxes checked, the lab will automatically incubate the sample 48 hours before testing it. State regulations in Texas allow TVMDL to pool up to 5 samples as a money-saving option for the producer. If you want the lab to pool your samples, you must write this on both the lab submission form and the test record. You must submit samples from each bull in individual pouches. Under state regulations, only the lab may pool your samples for an official test. Never attempt to pool the samples yourself. If the test detects trich in the pooled sample, the lab will test the samples from each bull to find out which ones are positive. Once the sample is placed inside a pouch, it must be protected from extreme temperatures and from sunlight. The sample must be protected from the time it is collected until it arrives at the lab. You must also maintain the temperature of the samples at between 10 to 38 degrees Celsius. To properly ship a sample for testing, you will need the following supplies: a leak-proof container, a resealable zipper storage bag works well, paper towels or another absorbent material. You may also use paper towels as packing material, a cardboard box with a styrofoam insert, packing tape, a completed test record, and a TVMDL submission form. You will also need a resealable zipper storage bag to protect your paperwork. You are now ready to pack your sample. First, wrap the pouch in a paper towel or other absorbent material. Place the wrapped pouch in a resealable zipper storage bag. Next, place the sample in the shipping box. Add enough packing materials to fill the void. This helps to protect your sample during shipment. Next, place your completed test record and submission form in the resealable zipper storage bag. Put these on the lid. Now, close the cardboard box and seal it with packing tape. Always ship the samples to the TVMDL by an overnight carrier. This helps to maintain the sample's viability for an accurate test. The only time you should use a cold pack is during very hot weather. If you insert a cold pack, use newspaper or other packing materials to protect your samples from direct contact with the pack. If you have questions or concerns, please call one of our full-service labs or visit the TVMDL website. You may also want to visit the website of the Texas Animal Health Commission.